Favorites to win the gold medal here, Natalia Vestemianova and Andrei Bukin of the Soviet Union. Still on the first of the three compulsory dances, remember this, called the Killian.
Now the difference between this couple and the previous couple is this one's greater flair, greater movement, sense of movement. More moves per second than the other ones, who are simple, traditional, and very elegant.
The unison of Russian pairs and ice dancers is
mind-boggling.
Remarkable, isn't it?
Yes. This dance, they are being extremely, extremely tight, with wonderful, deep outer edges. Look at them as they move around. No excess movement here, as we'll see it later in their free dance. Look at the depth there.
Privileged to watch something at this level.
The lean. Look at that. Wonderful.
All right. Vestemianova and Bukin of the Soviet Union, the favorites, and that is why.
I certainly think that there's probably little doubt that they will take first place over Klimova and Ponomarenko, whose real specialty is not in this Killian dance. Look at that. Now, look at the sweep of that movement. Look at the sweep, the lean, the preciseness of the stepping. Look at the lean that they're getting there, and the immediate lean over to this edge.
You hardly believe
this
these marks have been computed, and let's put them up there. This is really impressive. As the crowd applauds, look at that. 5-9, 5-8, 5-8, 5-7, 5-8, 5-8, 5-9, 5-8, and 5-8 of compulsory dances. That's really something.
Oh, you remember the sixes that Tor Valentin got just 4 years ago?
Yep.
This couple was second to them at that time. They're wonderful dancers. They're wonderful dancers.
And as they say in Calgary, after the first go-round, here you're standing. You have two Soviets, Canadians are third. The Americans right now are in the number five position in the ice dancing, and we'll have more of that for you tonight.